Hi, welcome back to CZR channel. Today I'm going to talk about the actual signal loss between the remote control and the aircraft. Oh, hold on, let me fix this. I think it's good now. Okay, I think it's good now, right? Oh, by the way, I'm using the Mavic Mini to film me at the moment. It's a pretty good small little drone that can get mostly everything done in different perspective when I'm alone. Oh, wait, it's happening again. Sorry for that. Just give me a second. It's not responding. What's happening? Why the aircraft ascend itself? Oh no. Wait. Hey, it's not responding to my remote control. Where is it going? Oh no, I think I'm gonna lose it. Most of the time, when the mobile device live feed goes black and white, or fully black screen, or maybe this, for drone that using the DJI Fly app, like the current Mavic Mini, Mini 2, and Mavic Air 2. Do you notice the difference? Both warning give similar impression, but does it represent the same thing? The warning message can be quite clear. In the same time, it can also be confusing. Especially some mobile device only partially display the warning message. Or maybe because generally, when we see black and white, or black screen, it probably only meant one thing. Disconnection or signal loss to the aircraft. I'm going to talk about the difference between these two warnings, what is happening, some idea on what you can do or cannot do, and to share a better alternative way to identify both of it. I will not include consideration on other factors like weather, wind, birds, obstacles, aircraft condition and battery, satellite count, compass, RTH altitude, and wrongly assumed boom point. Otherwise, the discussion of possibility will be too wide. So I will just keep it simple and in general. By the way, most of this factor and related information was already covered in my previous video on related topic, especially for the Mavic Mini. And some are general knowledge that apply to Mini 2 and Mavic Air 2 as well. So if you want to know more, you are most welcome to check it out. A quick explanation on what is fail-safe RTH and normal RTH. Fail-safe RTH will be initiated automatically by the aircraft itself and fly back to the home point after losing signal connection continuously for 11 seconds between the remote control and the aircraft. If under the setting, safety, advanced safety settings, this, the signal loss option is set to return to home or RTH. Normal RTH is when the return to home is manually engaged by the operator through the Fly app or by pressing the remote control RTH button. Let's start off with the warning that majority of us thought it was it. When you see this, it is correct that the remote control has lost signal connection with the aircraft. But was it completely? Or there are still tiny bit of unstable radio frequency wave being transmitted intermittently. I will divide two parts for this. The first part will be a complete 100% signal loss. The second part will be an incomplete or intermittent signal loss. Right after this warning appears, normally there will be another prompt out warning looks like this. And sometimes you may even see this. During this period of time, all input or instruction from the remote control will not be able to send or transmit to the aircraft. Assuming the aircraft is 100 meters distant away from the home point as an example, after continuously of losing signal connection for 11 seconds, the aircraft will then automatically initiate fail-safe return to home procedure and fly back to home point. This is just a simple illustration as each aircraft model has slightly different RTH pattern. But ultimately, if everything is in order, all of them will eventually return to the home point. Again, if everything is working as intended as previously mentioned, I will just wait at the home point while trying my best to adjust the remote control and the antenna to get the correct angle and direction towards the aircraft and hoping to get reconnection as soon as possible. Now, what happens if the signal connection is losing intermittently? let's take a look at this screen recorder video as a sample. It is important to know because in this case, the aircraft failed self-RTH, might not be able to initiate due to the incomplete 11 seconds of signal connection loss between the remote control and the aircraft. So if the operator do nothing and to wait for the aircraft to return by itself at the home point with the intermittent signal connection that keep on connect and disconnect, the aircraft will just hover there until the low battery initiating the return to home. And then the aircraft will only fly back to the home point. But that will be too much risk if it is distant or really far away. Okay, so the first signal connection loss warning appear now. Let's put a countdown timer and see what happened. At about 9 seconds, the aircraft got the signal connection back. So, no failsafe RTH. Look at this moment, the signal is really really weak by now. And another signal loss. For 3 seconds and picking up some signal. And disconnected again. The same things repeated for a few times until it finally lost for more than 11 seconds continuously, and only the aircraft decided to initiate signal loss option and return to home. It highly depends on the situation and the location the aircraft is flying. Regardless of what we decide to do, the important part is to determine and identify it correctly, whether it is a complete signal connection loss or an intermittent signal connection loss between the remote control and the aircraft by using the Fly App live feed, or another better alternative way, which I will talk about it later. Now let's move on to the second warning. RC not connected to mobile device. This happens when there are connection problems between the remote control and the mobile device. That is often caused by the cable or the connector in most cases I've come across, or a dirty phone port, or maybe a faulty remote control port. It has no relation of signal connection with the aircraft. The exact same message can be seen when we open the Fly App without connecting to the remote control. Basically, you just lost the live feed camera of the aircraft and all other information displayed on the mobile device during the flight. The remote control is still connected to the aircraft, and any input or instruction from the remote control will still transmit to the aircraft. Even the video recording still works as normal. We just can't see what exactly are we recording. You can still fly without the mobile device, but it is not recommended unless you know very well what you are doing. The failsafe RTH will not be initiated in this case, so don't wait for it unless the signal connection loss between remote control and aircraft occur after that. Since the mobile device is already disconnected from the remote control earlier, we will not see this warning anymore, and that makes us unable to know if the aircraft is still connected or disconnected from the remote control. Again, the alternative method will be the last option to determine what is actually going on. Check the cable connector on the mobile device. Make sure it is inserted properly. Remove the cable connector from the mobile device and reinsert it back. Replace the cable on the spot if you have a spare. If there's a visual on the aircraft, take your time to fly it back manually. Make sure to take note on the orientation of the aircraft and don't get disoriented with inverted remote control input and aircraft movement. If the visual of the aircraft is uncertain, bad, or totally could not be seen, then it's time to engage the normal RTH with the remote control by press and hold until you heard this beeping tone. That's it. Just wait for it at the home point. Let's hope that no other factors affecting the auto return to home. And make sure don't press the RTH button again or move any of the remote control stick as things may get complicated later, unless there is already a visual on the aircraft. You can walk or drive to the projected aircraft location, highly depending on the situation and surrounding, which I don't really recommend, unless you can be very sure that the remote control stay connected with the aircraft the entire time. Otherwise, the aircraft will initiate failsafe RTH once it lost connection for more than 11 seconds and fly back to the home point or generally from where you are coming from.
But the remote control already disconnected from the mobile device. How do I know?
Here comes the solution. This remote control lights indicator. I found it to be much easier to use and determine if the remote control is currently connected or disconnected to the aircraft or some other problem, like the cable, for example. Before that, let's take a quick 16 seconds to look how does the battery level indicator lights sequence looks like, so we don't get confused later. I guess you guys are well familiar with it. So let's see what happened next. When aircraft not connected to remote control warning appear, all the available or remaining battery light indicator on the remote control will all blink constantly together, indicating the remote control has no or lost signal connection and trying to search or link with the aircraft. Same thing happens when you turn on the remote control without turning on the aircraft. All the available lights will keep blinking while searching and trying to link with the aircraft. Until the remote control got connected with the aircraft, then it will change to the normal battery indicator, or I call it solid, indicating the connection has been successfully established and connected between the remote control and the aircraft. This is a side-by-side blinking difference to compare the current remaining battery earlier and the no connection or linking status. When RC not connected to mobile device warning appear, the light on the remote control will stay the same as battery indicator or solid. That indicates the connection between the remote control and the aircraft is still connected. So this does not represent the widely used term, signal loss. Some idea to remember it easily. If everything is working fine during a flight and suddenly something happened to the live feed, look at the remote control light indicator. If all available light is blinking, the aircraft has lost signal connection with the remote control. Then only decide the next course of action. Failure to find the actual root cause may have a great impact on the chances of getting the aircraft back. Please share around if you wish to help your community, as personally, I've seen quite a number of them losing their drone because of this confusion. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching and see you on my next video.